So in this session, we are going to talk about Control-M LDAP integration. So whenever a new employee joins in the organization, their ID is going to get created in LDAP account. Okay, so LDAP account is the place where if any new employee is joining as part of their onboarding process, their ID will get created and their employee ID will be generated. And also based on their role, their account is going to be created in one of the existing groups. So let's say if a new employee is joining as an admin, their account may get created under IT admin group. Or let's say if they are joining as a monitoring or as a scheduler guy, their account may get created under IT monitoring group. Now these are just the examples which we are taking in real life. In LDAP account, there will be hundreds or thousands of groups will be there based on the roles which any employee is performing or things like that. Now let's say whenever this employee is joining and they becoming part of, let's say, IT admin group or IT monitoring group, in that case we also want their ID to be automatically getting authenticated in Control-M Enterprise Manager. We don't want that there should be any manual effort in order to create new users account into Control-M. So Control-M EM and LDAP integration basically simplifies that process. So let's see how this is going to work. Okay, so what you do is that in Control-M CCM, Control-M Configuration Manager, you are going to create multiple groups. So for example, in this case, let's say I have a group which is called a CTM admin group. Okay, this is a group which we have. And then we have another group which is called CTM monitoring underscore GRP. Okay, so the first group I have given all the access, which is read, write, execute, and all the permissions. And the second group we have given only read permissions. So any user which is part of CTM admin group, they are going to have all kind of access on the jobs. They'll be able to read the job, they'll be able to define any job, they'll be able to execute job, they'll be basically able to do everything. And any user which is part of CTM monitoring group, they are going to have only the read access. So basically they are only going to monitor the jobs. They won't be able to have access of changing the jobs configuration or defining any jobs. Now in this case, we are not going to create any user in Control-M EM side. Okay, so whenever any new user is going to come, we are not going to create their account in Control-M EM. The account is just going to get created in LDAP. So how Control-M EM will know that what kind of access is to be provided to that user? Okay, so that happens actually during the integration. So when you do the integration of Control-M EM and LDAP, they actually sync with each other, and in that case you also have groups created in Control-M Configuration Manager, and those groups you define or you kind of map with the groups in LDAP. Okay, so in this case, let's say CTM admin underscore GRP you map with IT admin group, and then there is this another group which is called CTM monitoring underscore GRP. This group you mapped with IT mon group. Okay, so now any user which is going to get created in IT admin group, by default they are going to have all the access which you have defined under this group policy. Okay, so the user is still going to get created in LDAP, and then that user is going to have the access based on the permission which they are mapped in LDAP and Control-M CCM. Now the name of the group doesn't need to be same. So in LDAP, let's say the group name can be IT admin, and in Control-M Configuration Manager the group name can be the one which is defined here. Okay, so these names don't really need to be same. Now let's try to understand what happens when a new user joins the organization and how this process is going to work. So let's say this new user is called John. Okay, so he has joined the organization and he is part of IT monitoring group. Okay, and now when he tries to log into a Control-M EM client, in that case Control-M EM client is going to look for the user account in LDAP. Okay, so the account is going to be looked into LDAP and also going to be checked that which group this user is part of. So for example, in this case, this user is going to be checked in LDAP, and then after the scan it will be found that this user is part of IT monitoring group. Okay, as we can see that this user is part of IT monitoring group, and IT monitoring group is actually mapped with Control-M group, which is called CTM monitoring group. So in that case, authorization is and authentication is going to be successful, and the privileges which this newly created user is going to get is read-only permissions, And that's how the user will be able to basically authenticate to Control-M and will be able to get the authorized rights. Now the benefit of integrating Control-M EM with LDAP is that, let's say if this user decides to separate from the organization, in that case you just have to delete this user's account from LDAP. Okay, once this user's account is deleted from LDAP, in that case this user will not be able to log into Control-M EM. So basically that is the benefit of integrating all the applications to LDAP, because whenever there is deboarding process is happening, or whenever there is one employee separates from the organization, in that case they just need to delete that user account from LDAP, and then that user is just going to get no access on all the applications which that user was previously part of. Okay, so it really smoothlines the process of user authentication and user authorization, and also it gives you security that this account will not have any non-authorized access when he leaves the organization.